मॉर्निंग क्लास, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ चैप्टर 3. आई गेव दिस वर्क एज होमवर्क इन प्रीवियस वीक, बट आई एम डिस्कसिंग द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स सो दैट दोज हु कुडंट कंप्लीट इट दे कैन डू इट. मोर ओवर दोज हु हैव डन इट दे कैन ऑल्सो क्रॉस चेक देयर वर्क. ओके, सो नाउ वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. सो फर्स्ट यू टेक बुक and pencil so that you can mark answers while I'm telling it. Okay, so just pause the video and take book and pencil so that you can mark answers. Okay, so now we are starting with question answers. Question one is define watermark. So for this question, answer is on page number 45. Come on page number 45. On page number 45 in key points, watermark refers to a text or image that is shown as a dim imprint behind the text of every page in a document. This is your answer one. Okay, now we are moving to question number 2. Question number 2 is, what is page margin? So for the question number 2, answer is on page number 40. Come on page number 40. On page number 40, in the setting page margin topic, you can tick the answer. Page margin refers to the blank space around the edges of the page. The space seen on all the four sides of the page is called top margin, bottom margin, left margin and right margin. This is the answer for question number 2. I hope you have marked it. Okay, now we are moving to question number 3. Question number 3 is, what are the two main components required during a mail merge process? Question 3, what are the two main components required during a mail merge process? For answer of this question 3, come on page number 3. Now page number 42. On page number 42, right answer. Right answer, tick answer. The mail merge process requires following. First, main document. The document that contains letter or text which is to be sent is called the main document. I'm reading again. The mail merge process requires the following. First point is main document. The document that contains letter or text which is to be sent is called the main document. Second point, data source. The file where all the addresses of the recipients are stored is called the data source. I'm repeating the second point, data source. The file where all the addresses of the recipients are stored is called the data source. Now come on question number 4. Write the steps to create a drop cap letter. Write the steps to create a drop cap letter. For this answer, come on page number 35. Answer 4 is on page number 35. On page number 35, answer starts, to create a drop letter, follow the given steps. Step 1, step 2, step 3. You will write these three steps. Step 1, I am reading. Click in the paragraph that you want to begin with a drop cap letter. Step 2, click the insert tab on the ribbon. Step 3, click drop cap from the text group and choose the option from the list. See the effect on your paragraph. This is answer 4. Now move to question number 5. Question number 5 is, how do you apply column formatting on the selected text? How do you apply column formatting on the selected text? Answer for this is again on page number 35. in the paragraph applying column formatting. Come in the paragraph applying column formatting and write the steps. To apply column formatting, steps are: step 1, select the text you want to format in columns. Step 2, click the page layout tab. Step 3, click columns from the page setup group. Step 4, choose the number of columns you want from the list that opens up. Okay, these are the steps. Now, here comes question number 6. Question number 6 is, how do you replace the word good with very good in a document? For this, come on page number 20. On page number 30, you have to make steps. Okay, try to make steps. If you cannot, then let me know. I'll help you again. Okay, because there are too many steps. If I will read all the steps, that will be tough for you. Okay, so I'm just telling you the page number 30, 29, 30. From there, you make your own steps by reading. Okay, if still there is problem, I'll discuss it later. Okay. I can tell it to you on WhatsApp if there is problem. Now come to the next question. Steps to insert hyperlink in a document. Question 7. Write the steps to insert a hyperlink in a document. Come on page number 32. Steps to insert hyperlink. Come in the topic inserting hyperlinks. In that topic, steps are given. This note, I'm reading loudly. The steps: select the text on which hyperlink is to be inserted. Step 2, click the insert tab. Step 3, click hyperlink from the links group. Step 4 is quite big. You can make short it. Okay. Step 4 and 5, both you can write them briefly also. Okay. 6. Insert hyperlink dialog box. I'm reading 4th point. Insert hyperlink dialog box appears with various options through which you can create a link. Okay. Step 5. Type the address of the website in the address box or click any existing file from the list to create a link to that file. This much is enough. Then step 6. Click on the OK button. This inserts a hyperlink in your document. Okay. See, these steps questions, they are always for the practical purpose. Don't think like it's such a lengthy answer or it will come in exam, how will you write. So it doesn't come in this way, it will come in some other form. Okay, these questions are basically for practical purpose, but since we are doing the whole chapter question answer, so we have to write it. Okay. Question 8, how do you add a picture as a watermark in a document? Come on page number 37. For this answer, come on page number 37. Answer is, you come in the topic applying watermark. come in the topic, applying watermark. Now, to set watermark, steps are: step 1, open the document and click the page layout tab. Step 2, click watermark from the page background group. Step 3, select the style of the watermark and click it to apply on the page. Okay, so these are the steps for applying a watermark. But if we want to apply watermark as a picture, for that, now after this you come on 37 page, click picture watermark option, select picture button to insert a picture. The insert picture dialog box appears. Select the appropriate picture and click insert button. Click OK button on the printed watermark dialog box. The picture is added as a watermark on the page. Okay, got it? In this, first I told you the steps for, simple steps for adding watermark. Then we will write that click picture watermark. Okay, so it's on both the pages, 36 and 37. Now question number 9, write the steps to record and run a macro. Come on page number 40-41. On page number 40, steps, it's in the paragraph creating macros. Come in the paragraph creating macros. In that, to record and run the macros, steps are: first step, click view tab. Step 2, click the small arrow on the macros from the macros group. Step 3, again you can short these steps, okay? Or if you want to write them completely, you can write them. As I told you, 7 steps are there, but it's not like that you have to learn it in that way only, okay? This is for practical purpose, but we have to write it in the notebook. Now question answers are over. Now computer in everyday life application based questions. Hari has used a word processor to write his history homework. Name the word processing feature that he can use to find the synonyms and antonyms. So answer is thesaurus in review. Answer for this is thesaurus in review. Now I am discussing the fill in the blanks quickly. First fill up. Dash helps you to move quickly from one page to another page by simply clicking on a link. Answer is hyperlink. First fill up's answer is hyperlink. Second, you can follow a link by pressing dash key and clicking on the link. Answer for this is control plus click. Answer for second fill up is control plus click. Third, left, right, top, bottom are 4 types of dash. Answer is margins. Left, right, top, bottom are 4 types of margins. Fourth, in the mail merge process, the document that contains the letter to be sent is dash. Answer is main document. Answer for fourth fill up is main document. Question 5. To use mail merge feature, use dash tab on the ribbon. Answer is mailing tab. Fifth fill up answer is mailing. Okay, so now I have discussed question answers, their page numbers and fill up. So those who were having issues in completing work, they will complete it now, and those who have complete, just they can just check their work theirself by watching this video. Okay, this is all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.